So far we have looked at sulfonamides and cotrimoxazole, correct?
Yes.
So yeah, so now we want to look at quinolones. Can you say quinolones?
Quinolones.
So quinolones, the chemistry itself of these is quinolone.
Yes.
Okay. So far what we know, the chemical structure is quinolone. So here they have given you the structure. Quinolones.
And you should write neatly.
By mechanism of action, we have seen where fluoroquinolones or quinolones come. They come under DNA gyrase inhibitors. Okay.
Yes.
And these are synthetic antimicrobial agents. What are they? Synthetic.
Synthetic.
Synthetic. And these are antibacterial. So initially they were against gram-negative bacteria. Now they are even, the newer ones are against gram-positive also. So they have broad spectrum of action. Okay.
Yes.
Let us look at a few important questions asked from this chapter. So we are currently in the antimicrobial chapter. In
Yes.
that, sulfonamides, cotrimoxazole, quinolones. Okay. Now in this, we have seen sulfonamide, cotrimoxazole. Now we are into quinolone. Quinolone, we have, they have asked second generation mainly. Then they have asked mechanism of action. Ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin, p-floxacin, gatifloxacin. Okay, and third generation also they have asked. Okay. Now we have looked at the important questions. Let's move on. So let's start with the classification. So initially there was nalidixic acid. Okay. Then when they fluorinated it, they got fluoroquinolones. Okay. So let us look at these detail. Actually, what some of them do, they call this nalidixic acid itself as first generation, and this as second, and this as third. However, we will go with the KDT textbook. Okay. So the first generation fluoroquinolones will be norfloxacin. One thing you can note here, it is very easy actually. Floxacin, FLOXACIN, is constant. So easy, nowhere it changes. First look at that. Okay, floxacin, 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 floxacin. That much you can write off. Now add everything prefix. Norfloxacin, ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin, p-floxacin, levofloxacin. This is nothing but the ofloxacin itself, the active levoisomer. Then you have lumifloxacin, sparfloxacin, moxifloxacin, gemifloxacin, prulifloxacin. Okay, so this moxifloxacin is very new, I think, because I saw them classify this in the almost in the next generation. Okay, so let us just try to recollect. Norfloxacin used against UTI. Ciprofloxacin, it is a prototype drug. Ciprofloxacin is the prototype drugs. Then pay attention here. Ciprofloxacin is prototype. It is first line of drug for typhoid, they say, but ceftriaxone is the most reliable and fastest acting bactericidal agent for enteric fever. Okay, so ciprofloxacin, you remember. Apart from that, you can also give ofloxacin also for typhoid, even levofloxacin, which is nothing but levoisomer of ofloxacin. All these you can give for typhoid. Typhoid. This ofloxacin, they have written mostly about gonorrhea. Then you have p-floxacin. Then in second generation, you have levofloxacin, lomifloxacin, which is withdrawn, sparfloxacin withdrawn, moxifloxacin. It is most potent fluoroquinolone against Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Gemifloxacin is broad spectrum for community acquired pneumonia, for acute exacerbations of chronic bronchitis. Prulifloxacin, it is a prodrug of ulifloxacin. It is also broad spectrum. Now, how will you remember all this? Let's try, okay? Let's try to recollect. Let's put a new slide here. Norfloxacin. Floxacin is common. So let's take floxacin here. Norfloxacin. Ofloxacin. P-floxacin. And then there was ciprofloxacin. levofloxacin. Then two things which are withdrawn, not required, moxifloxacin. Then moxifloxacin, gemifloxacin, then prulifloxacin. Okay. Right? What has been asked in the exam? Ofloxacin has been asked so far. Right? Ofloxacin has been asked. Ciprofloxacin has been asked. P-floxacin has been asked. Something like gatifloxacin also has been asked. Wait. Okay, got some information on that. This gatifloxacin. Gatifloxacin. Is also second generation. It's banned in India. Okay, it's banned in India. It was frequently used for gram positive infections, but it caused QT prolongation, arrhythmia, phototoxicity, and unpredictable hypoglycemia, because of which it was discontinued in most countries and it is also banned in India. So, gatifloxacin, no need to remember. However, as they have asked in the exam, we need to know that. Okay. Let's just put that information here. Gatifloxacin banned in most countries and India. So, what is the difference between first generation and second generation? See, this nalidixic acid was fluorinated with one fluoro. So, it was first generation. When fluorinated with additional fluoro, okay, when fluorinated with additional fluoro and other substitutions, then it became second generation, and their spectrum also became broad. Substitutions, then you got second generation. Fluorinated with additional fluoro and other substitutes. So, how does it even make a difference? Basically, the antimicrobial activity was extended to gram positive, right? So, antimicrobial activity extended to gram positive cocci or cocci, okay, and anaerobes, and thus conferring metabolic stability, longer T half life, and they are more stable, right? That's what it says, longer T half, stable. So these are second generation. Okay, is this clear? Okay, so let's look at these diagrams. What exactly is there in this diagram? This is nalidixic acid. And this is ciprofloxacin, which is first generation. Ciprofloxacin, first generation. Okay. So, I think that's all we wanted to cover in this video. Let's just revise what we have seen so far. Quinolones, we started with quinolones. Chemically, we saw it's a quinolone. It inhibits DNA gyrase. That's how it is, mechanism of action. It is synthetic. Initially, it was gram-negative action. The newer drugs have gram-positive action. We saw the important questions. Then we saw the classification, first generation and then second generation. Okay. Levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, gemifloxacin, prulifloxacin. First generation, norfloxacin, ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin, p-floxacin. Okay. Then we saw what has been asked in the exam. These have been asked in the exam. Gatifloxacin, though it is banned, it has been asked in exam. Okay. Meet us in the next video. We will see mechanism of action, resistance mechanism, adverse drug reactions, details on ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin, p-floxacin, gatifloxacin. That's all. Okay. See you. Bye-bye.